Hello, my name is Paul Heister. I work in the product development group here at ACT, and today I'm going to be talking to you about our ICE-Lok wedgelock product. Traditionally in an embedded computing solution, you have a conduction card with heat sources, and those heat sources, the heat's conducted out to the rails here. And then once it reaches the rails, it goes through a wedge lock, which is in green here. Goes through the wedge locks and is conducted down to a cold plate, which rejects the heat. So it's a conduction-based solution, and part of that journey is through these green squares here, which are wedge locks. So in a traditional wedge lock, which is depicted here, there's basically two wedges which expand and clamp the conduction card into the chassis. So this creates two conduction paths. So one conduction path is through this contact here, and that's a resistance we'll call R1. And the second conduction path is through the wedge lock itself, and we'll call that R2. So that's our competitor. For ACT's ICE-Lok product, there are three conduction paths. So we have the same conduction path, R1, same conduction path, R2, but we have a third conduction path, R3. And that's due to the shape of our wedges being L-shaped, so that gives us an extra conduction path to get to the chassis. So this is beneficial when you're at the limit if an electrical component is close to its temperature limit. ICE-Loks can provide about 1 to 3 degrees Celsius in improvement, you know, depending on your heat loads of your electrical components. So you can see, you know, obviously each of these resistance paths is in parallel. So you can do some quick math to show the benefit of ICE-Loks. So for ICE-Loks, let's call it ACT. 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. So effectively 3 over R. And then for our competitors, same sort of thing. Our competitors, 1 over R1 plus 2. And that's, you know, 2 over R. So if you ratio those, so R ACT over R, oops, R competitor is effectively 2/3. So that should be easy to see and obvious, but it effectively reduces the thermal resistance of the wedge lock by 30%. Thank you.
Thanks for watching an episode of Engineers with Markers. We'd appreciate if you like this video and subscribe to our channel. Then make your way on down to the description for more resources. If you've got a question, leave it in the comments or visit the contact page on our website to talk with an engineer.